So I opened up. I actually kept some things open so that today we can save time. So yesterday we lost time. Yeah, I. But I. Who is this person? You've not put your name on the sheet, so I don't know whose work it is. Whose work is this? Anybody? Nirup, yes. Giving is the. I actually I don't want to say this, but let. Okay. So giving is the most selfish thing you can ever do. Paradoxical again. Giving is the most selfish thing you can ever do in your life. I have learned this from my mentor, my guru Mahatriya. Okay. Why? Because when you give, it's a law of life, you will gain. Only thing is, you should not expect any gain. If you don't have any intent to gain, then you are in a good space. But if you do giving with an intent to gain, then that is a wrong space to be in. That is why giving is a law of life. Okay. The universe has to give you back. Okay. So, whose work is this? May I know? Because the name is not written. So, if you are still around, I will review. Otherwise, I'll move on to someone else. This is bringing health and happiness in the life of our clients. Intend to reach each and everyone. So, see, your each. If your target audience is each and everyone, it is no one. You have to go specific. See, you have to become Amitabh Bachchan, angry young man, Shah Rukh Khan, romantic hero. We have very few exceptions like Akshay Kumar. Right, so that is why it is very important that you can do multiple things. You can play multiple roles. You can, but that is why again it's the same thing, right? That how creating your space in the market. So if you say that, you help organizations increase sales. That's all. Okay. But you can be a B2B sales expert. Or you can help organization improve their sales via cold calls. You can be someone who can help improve sales with the power of videos. Okay. Or you can be someone who only help retail business owners with a revenue of 5 crore increase their sales by 30%. Go specific. That I explained that earlier, it does not mean you're losing out other market. You are just trying to find your uniqueness in that market space with what you do best. Okay, so for example, if we say chartered accountant CA, now there are CAs who specialize only with trust building. Trust matlab the NGO trust kind of a thing, trust. Okay, that kind of stuff, foundation trust, that kind of trust. Okay. And there are some chartered accountants who focus only on GST. There are some who focuses only on your, what do you call balance sheet and all. I'm not very good in that space, so I will not take that example. But it is, you go specific. So if people are looking for, I am looking for someone who can take care of my foundation NGO, then I am looking for the chartered accountants who specialize only in that. So my chances of finding you will be higher. If I am an interior designer, okay, and I say I do interiors versus I say I only specialize in terrace gardening. Right? It is what of yours will help people enter the door that you are opening. That doesn't mean you cannot do other things. Okay. So that is the point. So I don't know whose sheet is this, so I'm going to move to next sheet because the name is not here. Both are same only. So let's look at Haridasan's work. Haridasan, are you there in the session? Let me check. Yes. So I'm going to allow you to speak. Why don't you share? Haridasan, are you there?
Yes,
Yeah.
ma'am. Hello.
Go ahead.
Yeah, a wonderful class, ma'am. What I learned is that whatever the subject, we have a process to follow. The process will decide our success.
Okay. No, so I what is your topic? See, I like your work here. Okay.
Yeah.
Being a professional trader using become a, this is very good. Your outcome is good,
yeah.
But you can further refine this outcome. Become a professional trader using technical analysis. So, yeah. What happens when somebody becomes a professional trader?
Yeah, there is a process.
No.
There is some process, outcome, yeah?
Outcome of becoming a professional.
Yeah, the outcome is becoming a professional trader.
Sorry?
The outcome is our client to become a professional trader.
No. Suppose I want to, I take your course and I become a professional trader. So why do I want to become a professional trader? Because I can guide people better and I can make more money.
Okay.
That is the outcome.
Okay.
See, nobody wants to become a professional trader. What will happen when they become a good professional trader using technical analysis? They will be able to predict better. Their chances of losing money will be less. They can help their clients make more money. In turn, they can also make more money.
Okay.
That is the outcome. Got it?
Yeah.
So that is how you have to orient it. Okay. So, because people buy outcomes. So you can say that learn how to, your outcome could be, it will be learn how to, see, we have to look at all of the gain statement that you have written. Then we can come up with something nice, all the gain statement. But basically, it is using the power of technical analysis, become a professional trader who everybody wants to work with.
Yeah.
That is what they want. No, I should get more and or easily fetch clients. Or reduce the risks of losing money, reduce the risk of your client's loss of money, whatever it is. Okay, you would know better, right? I'm just ideating.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. So your stuff, you guys would know very well. Okay, this your KBCs are good. I like you have created KBC4. So you should also actually, a lot of people can create more KBCs because you may have more content. But see, in one session, you can just say first three and then you can create a series and do the next three in next session. Like that. Like next video session. So, okay. Any questions you have for me? Anything that you were struggling with, did not understand, want to ask any? Your questions are good. Okay. So I'm happy with that. Your KBC you've understood. In fact, you went ahead with KBC 4. So I'm happy with that. So that you can now in each KBC also, as I said, you can be just talk the KG level of this stuff. And then you go into middle school. Then you go to pre-primary, primary. That kind content-wise, right? For somebody who does not understand anything, that becomes your conceptual course. Yeah. Then to primary, then to middle school, then to higher secondary, whatever, that. So your same KBC1 can go in more depth.
Yeah.
And you can have superficial multiple KBC. Suppose for this topic, you have 20 knowledge byte concepts.
Yeah.
So you can just say you want to position yourself as an expert online, you have to build your influence. Every day do one, two, three, next day do next three, next day do next three. In continuation, create episodes. What is there? Okay. So that is, do you have any questions for me?
Do you want to create videos for every KBC?
Sorry? Yeah, you can do video for every KBC also. Of course. If your topic has that much content, please go ahead. So that is why it depends on, your specific need. You can do for each KBC also. Perfect. But keep it short, 2-3 points because people can't absorb that much.
Yeah.
That is the issue. Keep it short, 5 to 10 minutes maximum.
Okay.
And have some 3 or 4, 5 pointers or you will speak only on that. Okay.
Point to point, okay.
Yeah, pointers for you. Pointers so that, okay, I want to cover these 5 things definitely in this topic, which is your internal stuff, not external. It is for internal reference, your reference. Okay, so, okay, may I know why did you join this program and how the program has been for you?
A wonderful program.
Okay, so why did you join my session? I mean, what was so exciting in FB for you to join?
Because I was working for some companies, and now I am planning to do my own as a professional teacher.
Okay.
So I thought I have some inputs. That is why I joined this. I think it is worth.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you, madam.
Yeah. Thanks. So now let's look at building confidence in chemistry. Atira, are you there? Let's see if she's here. Can you mute yourself, Haridasan? Otherwise, I'll have to mute you.
Yes, madam, I'm here.
Yeah, yeah. One second. Okay, he muted. Okay. So, see, build confidence in chemistry. Okay. Outcome should actually, Atira, little there is, you still have some disconnects in the understanding. So it is building, it is more like scoring well in chemistry is an outcome. Build confidence is also good gain, but you across one of your gains, this should be score well.
Okay.
Now your first, what are the ways to build confidence that it is not relevant? I mean, this is very broad. Right? Your first, second, third, fourth question, fifth, until fifth is not, it is very, anybody can see, yesterday we looked how to boost the confidence of a child. They can also talk on these questions. No, you are talking specifically with respect to chemistry or general overall?
That's related with chemistry.
So that is why you have to refine these questions. Your first, only this chemistry tips and tricks is good. How to study chemistry easily is good. How to study chemistry for exams is good. Now for which exam? 5th class, 10th class, 12th class, first year, whatever it is, qualify that further.
Okay.
Score well in chemistry, where again, for which class? For 7th class, you will have separate, 8 separate approaches or hacks to score well in chemistry, right? That you will cover, that you can title it, super hacks to score well in chemistry for grade 8.
Okay, ma'am.
That is what people will be searching for. Agar when somebody will just simply write how to score well in chemistry, lot of things will open up. So the more specific you go, narrow you go, I understand this is first version, no problem. But, you can think on those lines also what I'm sharing right now.
Sure, ma'am. Sure.
How can I improve my confidence in chemistry? That is a good question, right? So your last, these four are good, but your upper ones are not relevant, okay? I mean, they will... it will not work, okay?
Concentration,
practice and revision. And yeah, your KBCs, so anyways, all of you, that's your stuff. You should be doing your KBCs very well, okay?
Yeah, okay, ma'am.
Ask me any questions you have for me?
Yeah, ma'am, I'm a bit confused with these questions. And that was what, I chose the different questions. And then I refined myself. But that... question refining was not in the proper place. That is what happened, ma'am.
Yes. So first of all, you guys are doing awesome. Okay. As far as first timers here, your first versions are very good. You're thinking in right direction. But now because I'm looking at it from an expert perspective, I have to give those corrections to you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
So it's about that, okay? But everybody who has done their assignment, I'm so super impressed that in such a short time online, you guys are moving at a very good speed. Your thoughts are, you're aligning your thoughts. Things are coming out well. You've taken actions. I'm very impressed, okay? I'm looking at, for me, it's always a better version of what you're doing. So your last three things are, four, five things are very good, but the first things are very broad. Anyone can work on that topic, but you have to keep your focus to chemistry and you can further narrow it down to that specific age group or classes, grades.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am.
All right, Atira. Let's look at who's next. Mohan. Mohan. Yeah, vision. So a diversified organization with solutions for multiple problems. Mohan is there in the session. Let's see if Mohan is there. Mohan is not there. So should I review, not review? What should I do? Okay, Mohan, your vision statement, your mission statement is good, but your mission state vision statement needs to be revised. Okay, because it is you know, as a recommendation would be you're helping people, students, employability skills is what you are working on, right? So you will have to refine your vision with, as I shared today, it has to be an aspiration. It has to be the change you want to see in the world. So what will happen when somebody comes to your program and when you're able to give them employability skills at reasonable cost, what is the end outcome that will happen in the society because of that? That should become your vision statement. Okay. So your values, what you have written in values is actually a mission also for you. So both of these are mission only for you. Okay, this is not values. I have given a document today, mission, vision, values, refer that. Okay, your story is good. I went through this, but your pains are not written properly. Okay, this definitely, I mean, not written, it's not like that. I mean, these will not fetch you customers. Because this is from your perspective. What is the person who is not finding, who is not able to clear the exams, written exams, what are they going through? When they fail in campus interviews, what is that they go through? That is the pain. It's the pain, the emotional pain, mental pain, the people are going through who are not able to clear the written tests or interview. So that you have to orient everything in that direction. Okay. So that is one thing. So once you do that, your outcome will also come appropriately. Currently, only your system looks good. Okay. So make sure that you, align your pain gain properly. That's the input I have for you. Let's see who is next. Bijal Garbhasanskar. Let me see if Bijal is around. Okay, I don't have Bijal also here. This also needs refinement. Co-creating. I have no issues with you using that word, but co-creating. Nobody would like to co-create their baby with an outsider. Okay. So you will, though it's not, it use in right context. I think you like the word, that's okay. But you have to use it in the right context, okay? So not at the place where you are using right now. That is an input I have for you. And this, your pain, USP needs complete revision. Okay, this is still something that you have not understood properly or there's a disconnect. So this has to be oriented because if this is not done right, your communication will not be right everywhere. That crystal clear clarity will not happen from top to down when you're talking about how you're helping people with their unique offering, what is the pain they are going through, what is the gain. This everything needs to be, revised. Okay. So these are the features that you have written. This is not the gain the customer will get. I've been saying that there is a difference in the features of your product and the outcome people will get because of these features. For example, you buy AC. Do you buy AC because it has a 5-star rating or, it has, whatever. It has been built with a specific technology. All those things come secondary. First of all, why have you gone to buy AC? Is because of for your own comfort and convenience, because you want to relax, you want to be in an, when it is peak summer time, you don't want to sweat. So you're looking for your comfort and convenience, and hence you have gone for bought an AC. Then you look at now you decided to buy AC because it helps solve it gives you a very, relaxing environment. You there's so many benefits. So after that, when you're making a decision to purchase, then you look at, okay, which AC? But buying AC, you have decided no. So all these things that you have written is, which AC? But now you have to decide why AC. Okay, so for your program, why Garbhasanskar? And then what are the features of your offering? Currently, your gains you have listed as features. You need to revise this, okay, if you really want to make the most of this. Okay. So that's about it. These are the work things I had. Do we have a perfect sample of all the assignment as a role model? People, it has to complete. That's why I've been building every day. If somebody is doing it end to end, I am more than happy to take it one sample review end to end. If everybody, but there are pieces that someone has done good, there are pieces. So end to end flow, that happens in the 30-day challenge. Again, the end to end. It first of all, in 5 days, we've achieved a lot. But that end-to-end, that seamless flow you're trying to seek will happen in the 30-day challenge for all the participants, not just one. Because we work on all these four things, right? Your personal clarity sheet, that is the most important section we work. In fact, I have an advanced blueprint for 30-day challenge. I've added a few more things there, which is an advanced. So 1 week we work on that. In fact, almost 1.5 we work on that. Then we work on the content bank creation. Then looking at the questions, because your everything is dependent on this. It needs time, because then your chances of success increases and chances of failure reduces. So I don't simply say things for the sake of saying. So for me, it is important that we do what we achieve, but that's where, you know, that much commitment, that much momentum is needed from your end. So as you see across these 4 days, the assignment level is dipping. So this is the challenge. That is why action taking is so important. I can give you thousands of ideas, thousands of strategies, and I apply for myself, right? Unless there is an application, the strategies is nothing, right? So there, the application has to happen on your work. So that's where those who are taking action, they are getting necessary inputs, they are moving ahead. Those who are simply absorbing the knowledge, fine. If they want to just simply absorb right now, whatever stage they are, it's the personal, very personal call. But if you really want to shift from offline to online and want to leverage the power of this digital revolution that is happening and the new age business model, which I call the golden age business model now, our knowledge, digitization and monetization is the golden age business model. Because apna time aa gaya. This era is of knowledge givers. Anyone from anywhere can learn from anyone. So if you have something valuable to share. So with that said, I wish you good night. Take care. And I will see you tomorrow. We will cover tools, budgets, and the end-to-end workflow of now you have created, assuming you have recorded your course, you have created your course. What are the options, how you can publish your course, various models, low-cost model to having on being on a learning management hub, to creating your own learning management hub, where there is one-time cost to creating the payment gateway, and how do you connect everything together? Basically, payment gateway and the hub, that is more important. If you are from the website, how everything, you know, how you attract the lead magnet, I will try to see if I can cover all of that. The how to part is mostly implementation. What I'm teaching you exactly same, I have to implement, that is what I'm teaching you, right? So the how to part, we will be 30 days, we will do a lot of things. I exactly teach you how to upload your courses in Teachable, how to create your courses, sections, everything. But tomorrow you will get a glimpse into everything so that you understand the entire workflow. And I will be making an offer. On day one itself, I shared the price points that you can work with me. I've tried to keep it affordable to every pocket size, depending upon how hungry you are for your growth or what is your current situation right now. And then... we will look, I will be making an offer, and those who want to come on board, I'll be very happy to have you on board, and then we will see how to take it from there. Thank you, everyone. Have a good night. Okay. See you tomorrow. Yeah. Good night. Take care, guys. Good night.